Well, the education system across the United States, Australia, India has been acquired from the English education system. So the roots are the same. And if you actually look at the roots of the education system, it was really designed to create workers for entrepreneurs. So during the Industrial Revolution, very few people actually went and did educational degrees. In the information age, the numbers increased. Today we're at a point where the supply is massively exceeds the demand. All corporations and governments and entrepreneurs are looking for people who can get results and solve problems, not people who are entitled because they have a degree. So even though right now majority of corporations may still be expecting degree educated people, based on the future trends, this is going to definitely change. Already we have the top 15 companies in the United States who have already said that they're not looking for people with degrees. So this is going to happen in India as well. The other thing is, with the $7 trillion disruption that is expected to happen in the job market, plus 800 million jobs that are expected to go in the next 10 years, you're going to have a lot of people who have wasted a significant amount of time and money into developing the type of education that is simply not going to be in demand in the future. Now, apart from some professions which require technical expertise, like being an architect, being an accountant, so on and so forth, a lot of degrees are kind of irrelevant. So clearly that education is not sufficient. We're not saying remove it, we're just saying balance it. To only teach people how to develop IQ, which teaches people memorization, analytical skills, and reasoning skills, but it doesn't teach people social awareness, self-awareness, relationship management, self-management, doesn't teach them money management, doesn't teach them influence, doesn't teach them leadership, doesn't teach them personality development, doesn't teach them how to balance their own emotions and confidence. I mean, it's a huge problem because we're human beings. 90% of our decisions are emotional and irrational. Only 10% are logical. So our entire education system is making the assumption that human beings and the world works on logic. So it's almost like we're deliberately failing people. At the each event, I mentioned that the two things that are underpinning the traditional education system worldwide are, number one, that academic excellence equals success, which we know is not the case. You only have to look at all university professors or PhDs and how many of them are struggling in life. And then the second is that IQ equals intelligence. Already research is coming out that the most successful CEOs in the world have high levels of EQ. Not only that, you need to have money awareness, you need to have spiritual awareness, you need to have emotional awareness. So many people are lacking in those skills. I actually find it quite phenomenal that here we are in 2020 and we are still putting people through an outdated education system and nobody's up in arms about it. It's just like completely acceptable. But we also have to understand the reason it's acceptable is because the human mind is capable of rationalizing any belief. And the way humans think is, we find safety in numbers. So we always, psychologically, we are wired to be a herd animal, meaning that if millions of people are doing the same thing, we will not question it. We will automatically make the assumption that if everyone's doing the same thing, it must be the right thing. But that's not the case. So far, statistics are telling us that majority of people are not inspired. Gallup polls are telling us that over 75% of people are disengaged in the workforce. Any happiness survey is telling you that majority of people are not happy, not inspired, not fulfilled. If you look at statistics around suicide, depression, anxiety, they're on the rise. Statistics around bankruptcy, business failures on the rise. Statistics around obesity and health issues are on the rise. So we are clearly starting to see an area where we're starting to see that there is no correlation between how educated you are and what an amazing life you have. Having said that, we need to redefine the word education, and we need to make sure that education is not just about IQ and academic excellence, that there are other elements that are missing need to be incorporated within that as well.